Hi, this is the Price Action Analyst. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I had a subscriber request today for this coin. It's Dagcoin, DAG is the coin code. I have already framed up support and resistance lines. So these are weekly bars. So this start date low is still the low. And then you had a big buying surge here and a retrace and then a buying surge and then the volume stepped in and it's gone to an all-time high and it's retraced and kind of consolidated in this downtrend for roughly a year. So if we go to the daily bars, there's a couple of things I noticed. So this beginning of the upsurge is kind of, it's a support level based off of here and here as well. And so you've got air there, which is now, well, yeah, it's pretty much filled. Then you've got this pivot, and there was a big surge off this pivot and another support level. And so the reason I'm looking at this is because, you know, this is a pivot here and you've got a pivot wash and then strength off of that. And then price came down and washed this pivot here and strength off that. And it's, you know, it's forming this trend line, but you know, it's trying to push higher. It's retraced again. And so this is important too. This has washed this pivot here. And again, now you've got, you know, more strength than here. This was two separate legs. This is just one push up. And I like to see that off the wash here. Also, you've not just got a wash of this low off this support level. You've also got essentially a filling of that air almost. So very strong move off of that. And so, you know, that this support level might be the support level in which the move, happens is what I'm trying to say. You know, if this pivot here hadn't been washed on that move, I'm less positive about it, but it's kind of, you know, it's washed this pivot and filled this air. And so that's a good place for me to be more to for that move to start from and for me to be more sure that this might be a breakout. So again, you can see it here. Look at the upward momentum. It's starting to get steeper and steeper. So, and now instead of getting, you know, retraces, now you've got a really shallow retrace, which we'll look at in the hourly bar. Sure, there's some wicks here, but after the wicks, look at the retrace. It hasn't really gone very far, and you know that air is offered support and it's left a big wick, and now you've got wicks within that, and so it looks like price wants to push higher here. So if I couldn't look at hourly bars, I might even say that you know that would be your zone to enter. And you know, if price doesn't come back here, it's so close to this zone, you could just buy it now, especially if you're planning on holding this for a while. You know, there's a little bit of air here, but if this does what I think it's going to do, I don't think this is coming back. I think this was the last retrace here and this is the push up. So if we go down to the hourly, let's get my bearings again. So here's your push up on the hourly, and then this is the retrace. Thank you. And again, within this retrace, you've got a big push up as it came into support and retested these highs and got into this air here. You've had the big push up. The retraces are not as steep as this, so the momentum's on the upside. And price has tried to push lower there and been fiercely rejected. So, and again, this is kind of the same thing on the hourly frame now. This retrace is very, very shallow, and price is actually breaking out of here right now. So, no matter how you frame that up, that's, I mean, it's not substantial yet, but that this is likely just gonna do that. That's what I see. I see strength there, especially in the context of this coming up. So I'll just go back to that, to the daily bars. Yeah, so that you had price come back down to the support level and push up. So the hourly bars just reaffirm what I see on the daily. But here's your giveaway. This big push up and this really shallow retrace, this, expect this to push up out of here. And so now if you get this retest of this trend line again, after you've had a false breakout here, you had another push up, which is a test of this trend line, you've had this test here and a really shallow retrace, now it's going to test again. So again, the more times it does this, the more chances there are that's breaking, and the strength coming into this is very strong. You had a very shallow retrace, so that's it's possible. You might get a little bit of weakness in between these two wicks here, but I think that might be your worst case scenario. And, it could just push out of here. This is strong. You might get some weakness up here too, but by the time that's happened, prices now cycled, from this very significant low where it washed, it's now come up through support to resistance, through resistance, which is now support, and up to another resistance level. So it's actually, when it gets up here, it's actually now uptrending. If it does this and gets up here, it's now in an uptrend. So if you see strength coming up to here and another really shallow retrace, expect it to push higher. So I don't mind the look of that. You got volume building there. So I'm a little bit hesitant, because you shouldn't really look at charts and go, all right, it's buy it now. But if this fails and price comes back here, these wicks are going to offer a lot of support. So sometimes you'll see a quick dip in there and another big wick, and then that's the last push. But that's likely to hold. So yeah, my bias would be to the upside here. I'm just trying to think as to how I could be wrong in that assessment. Because you've got a push from support to resistance, and then a deep retrace and a wash, and now it's pushed back up to these. So, this is a clear rejection of these levels here. So my bias would have to be up here. I'd be surprised if you see price cycle back down to this trend line. It is possible, but I think a push up here and then a really big push down, like on strong momentum, is low probability. So I would be willing to take a chance there. The only thing I would say is you're on the upper side of the Bollinger Bands, which is not ideal, but I like to try and hit these down here. But given what's happened, I think this is going to continue on. So if you're bullish the coin, then you could I wouldn't crucify you for buying it here. Okay, I think I'll leave it there. That's kind of my best guess. I'm kind of, I don't know. Again, it's just a matter of probabilities, but I would say, what I've drawn in there, that's kind of the high probability direction, I would say. So I hope that's helpful. Price is at 5290 Bitcoin. And I did notice on the dollar thing, so that is about to make a new high on against the US dollar, and that also looks like it's going to push higher too. So these wicks here are a bit of a giveaway. You've got wicks here and you've got a retrace, but look, it's clearly been rejected. So, and you've got strength coming into it. So, if that pushes higher against the dollar as well, you'd expect that to have a positive effect against the Bitcoin pair. So that's my assessment of DAG. Hope that's helpful. Like the video and subscribe. And if you're interested, check out the subscription service. I'm also on Twitter at Price Analyst. Thanks for watching.